One of our students recently brought in a malfunctioning Doepfer A160 clock divider, which had been sitting in the closet for about 1 year after accidentally being connected to a Eurorack power source in reverse. It had emitted the smell of burning plastic, at which point he quickly turned off the power. But the damage was done. The module powered up, but provided no signal or power to the bottom four clock divisions. When we met for our next office hour, our scheduled online discussion times each week for current students, we took a look at the module to see if we could find the fried component together. A simple visual inspection can yield a good deal of information about what might be wrong with any malfunctioning module. First, we powered up the unit to see which parts still function. Upon inserting a clock source, the second division port and LED seemed to be operating properly, but the fourth division was acting strangely, and the rest were not functioning at all. We removed the module from the case and power to examine the PCB. Looking closely at the board and components, I did not notice any of the telltale signs of burned components or bloated capacitors, or any other sign of damaged parts. The board looked brand new, and all of the components seemed intact. The only other part that seemed like it could possibly be an issue was the integrated circuit at the heart of the A160. Integrated circuits are small chips that contain entire circuits, each kind of chip performing a different task. I used a magnifying glass to read the faded print on the chip, which read CD4024BE. Using this number, we searched for the chip on Google, quickly finding the appropriate datasheet which explained exactly how that chip worked. Armed with this info, I took a trip to a local electronics shop. They had a replacement chip made by Motorola in stock for only $2, certainly less than the cost of shipping online. In the following office hour, we went back to the clock divider and removed the original integrated circuit, paying close attention to the alignment of the indentation at the end of the chip. I made sure that the new chip popped into place in the same direction, and we hoped for the best. Upon returning the module to the case, we were amazed to see that the previously malfunctioning LEDs were illuminated. Testing each division output, they all operated correctly. High fives went around and a module was brought back to life. Of course, had we found a burned component, we could have easily replaced it as well with a bit more effort. And this would be much more difficult with surface mount components. But this fix required $2 and no soldering. Thanks for watching and sharing, and as always, please like, follow, and subscribe.